Gross domestic product is the defining metric of the last 80 years. It arose from the ruins of the Great Depression to serve as the ultimate measure of an economy's welfare, the indicator to end all indicators. But GDP's long run may be coming to an end. Until the 1930s, national government's only aggregate statistical measurement of the economy was tax estimates. But after the Great Depression, U.S. policymakers sought a new way to understand the economy's health. In 1937, Simon Kuznets, an economist at the National Bureau of Economic Research and future Nobel laureate, gave them what they were looking for. GDP represents the total dollar value of all goods and services produced over a particular time period. It's most commonly calculated using the expenditure method, which adds up what everyone spent over a given period. An alternative method, the income approach, adds up what everyone earned. The notion that all economic production by individuals, companies, and the government could be captured by a single measure proved irresistible to policymakers the world over. Following the 1944 Bretton Woods Conference, which established the modern international economic order, GDP became the standard for assessing an economy and, by extension, its people's welfare. GDP growth became, and remains, every government's goal. Yet GDP is a blunt measurement tool, to say the least. After all, short-term GDP growth can be fueled by activities that pollute or degrade the environment or reduce leisure time. Nor does GDP account for activities with long-term social value, like unpaid housework and childcare. And it doesn't reflect inequality, which has risen sharply in recent decades. As the economist Moses Abramovich put it in 1959, "We should be highly skeptical of the view that long-term changes in the rate of growth of welfare can be gauged even roughly from changes in the rate of growth of output." Over the years, efforts have been made to overcome, or at least offset, some of GDP's shortcomings. In 1972, the King of Bhutan declared that he would work to increase not GDP, but GNH, or Gross National Happiness. In 1990, the United Nations launched the Human Development Index, which includes factors like gender equality, literacy, life expectancy, and school enrollment. And in 2006, China created a new index for green GDP, a measure of national economic output that accounts for some environmental factors. China's green GDP for 2004 was found to be 3 percentage points lower than its conventionally measured GDP. This points to a key reason why none of these alternate frameworks has really come close to dethroning GDP. After decades of chasing output growth, many politicians are not prepared to address the thorny and potentially costly implications of a more nuanced definition of human welfare. In 1999, the U.S. Commerce Department named GDP one of the great inventions of the 20th century. But that was then. However politically difficult it may be, the increasingly complex and interdependent global economy of the 21st century may require a new way to measure its health.